servant of all. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., translation of these scriptures, says, if you want to be important, wonderful. If you want to be recognized, wonderful. If you want to be great, but recognize that he who is greatest among you shall be your servant. The inductees of Delta Mu Delta International Honor Society in Business Administration, Epsilon Sigma Chapter, have found themselves in the unique, but to some, a familiar place. The billows and raging storms in your life have not, cannot, and will not ever be predicted by a meteorologist. That is because these storms come in the form of haters and naysayers. But what did your mama tell you? If no one is talking about you, then you need to take yourself to the mirror and re-examine what it is that you're not doing, because clearly you're off the radar. This is not your situation, however, because when you have made the decision, like leaders do, to travel in the road less traveled, or to even go so far as to create your own road confusing the GPS, others take notice. Truth be told, we need the haters, the naysayers, the who does he think he deserves, and the who does she think deserves. Their roles are vital in the development of your strength, the conviction of your faith, and the discernment of your spirit of discernment. They ensure that you don't get comfortable. How else will you sharpen your game, stay on your toes, prove that you are uniquely great? See, the command to be fruitful has always been mistaken for bearing children only, when in actuality, it also means plant your seed, water it, nurture it, watch it grow, and bear fruit so others in the community of your household, the geographical location you call home, as well as others across our planet, unknown to you, may also be nourished. Your gift, your seed planted within you from your conception, is for you to discover, nurture, so you can become the fruit for which we all have been waiting. How will this world be left a better place simply because you are in it? How will this world be left a better place because you are in it? Putting aside the kind gestures you have done for others when no one was looking, or the decision you made to smile instead of frowning, the mere fact that you are sitting here may not tell us decisively how you will make a tangible fingerprint in society, but it certainly tells us that you will. It is evident that as you sit here as the top 20% of your class, you have endured some bruising, perhaps some tearing above the eyes, perhaps some stop along the way to catch your breath moments. But isn't that symptomatic of the few who are chosen from the many called? Mother Teresa, Mahatma Gandhi, Bob Marley, Harriet Tubman, Nelson Mandela, you. Yes, you. Those who have impacted a community on a global scale are no more noteworthy than those who have impacted a community on a local scale, because every tower built started with one brick. I can say unequivocally that you have impacted these walls in the School of Business and Public Administration. You have shaken them with your force of resilience and commitment. You have mastered the art of silencing the maddened crowd. You set aside yourself from others. I am going to end with a story I tell my mentees. It is called The Eagle Who Thought He Was a Chicken. A baby eagle became orphaned when something happened to his parents. He glided down to the ground from his nest, but was not yet able to fly. A man picked him up. The man took him to a farmer and said, "This is a special kind of barnyard chicken that will grow up big." The farmer said, "Don't look like no barnyard chicken to me." "Oh, yes, it is. You'll be glad to own it." The farmer took the baby eagle and placed it with his chickens. The baby eagle learned to imitate the chickens. He could scratch the ground for grubs and worms, too. He grew up thinking he was a chicken. Then one day, an eagle flew above the barnyard. The eagle looked up and wondered, "What kind of animal is that? How graceful, how powerful, and free it is." Then he asked another chicken, "What is that?" The chicken replied, "Oh, that's an eagle. But don't worry yourself about that. You will never be able to fly like that." And the eagle went back to scratching the ground. He continued to behave like the chicken he thought he was. Finally, he died, never knowing the grand life that could have been his. That's one ending, but here's mine. The eagle said to itself, "They may have tried to teach me their language of inferiority, mediocrity, plainness, but despite all their efforts, I know who I am. I know in which lineage I was created. And as much as it pains me to separate from the only family I've known, I've got to spread my wings and fly, as that is my true destiny. That is the essence of Delta Mu Delta Epsilon chapter. Your reach must be such that below you there is nothing but air. May there be no heights you cannot attain, no love you cannot deceive, and no dreams you cannot